Watkins from Your Black World, and I was thinking about the thing with Stephen A. Smith. I'm in my hotel. I'm in Memphis, and but I just had to say this real quick and basically explain that ESPN is really screwing up when it comes to how they handle the Stephen A. Smith as opposed to how they've handled other controversies in the past. It's interesting to me that Stephen A. Smith will get suspended for comments that he made that were really actually quite harmless for the most part, other than the fact that he didn't clarify things as well as he could have when he used the word provoked. But it sounded to me like he was talking about situations where a woman hits a man, which we know it's not acceptable for anybody to hit anybody in a relationship. And also, I think that Stephen A. probably screwed up by bringing up this counterexample in a situation where Ray Rice had just knocked out his ex his fiance. I mean, that's just not acceptable. We know that. But at the end of the day, what did happen though was Skip Bayless, the other co-host, and another host who was on at the same time, helped Stephen A. clarify what he was saying. So the female co-host said something like, "So what you're saying is that no one should hit anybody in a relationship?" And he said yes. And then Skip Bayless said something else that helped him clarify it. And basically, Stephen A., for the most part, his comments really weren't that bad. Ken Williams, who's a former police officer who's reviewed tons of domestic violence cases, probably hundreds, basically broke down on Boss Sports. It's brothersonsports.com, where black men talk about sports. On brothersonsports.com, Ken Williams literally lays out exactly why Stephen A. what he said was not a problem. He broke out the different forms of domestic violence and said if Stephen was referring to this particular type, then it's not a problem what he said. Now, if he's saying that a woman can provoke a man into punching her by just yapping at him, well, obviously we agree that's not a problem. But Stephen A. consistently reiterated that domestic violence is not acceptable, that hitting a woman is not acceptable. And I know what it was. I think that Skip Bayless might have asked Stephen A. something like, "So you're saying that it's not acceptable to hit a woman?" And Stephen A. said, "No, it's not." So, what's interesting though is the politics behind all this. Now, here's what's interesting now. When you look at ESPN, they're screwing up in every single way. ESPN is basically telling their commentators, "Look, we want you to go out way outside the lines. We want you to dig into social commentary, talk about the issues of the day, talk about anything that's going on in our space, as long as it's connected to sports or connected to an athlete. Okay, fine, that's going to get you ratings." But here's the thing: two problems. Number one, your analysts are not trained to do social commentary. They don't have degrees in sociology or in political science or in gender studies or in racial studies or, Africana studies. They don't have the certifications necessary to even do this kind of analysis. So they end up making themselves look stupid, and they make the network look stupid. And at the same time, they not only make themselves look stupid and the network look stupid, they put their careers in jeopardy and put the network in jeopardy. You saw Rob Parker made those remarks about RG3, where he basically asked the question that a lot of brothers ask, which is he a real brother or is he a cornball brother? If you remember that, and he brought up the fact that RG3 has a white wife. And a lot of brothers look at RG3 and say, "Yeah, what kind of brother is he?" It's not to say that he's cornball necessarily, but if he's talking the Republican jibber jabber or just sort of doing things that black men don't understand, we ask ourselves that question. Now, I'm not saying what the answer should be. I'm not saying that at all. But what I am saying is it's okay to ask a question, right? Especially on a network where you're encouraged to ask the hard questions, to make the hard commentary and all this other stuff. So what happens? They fire Rob Parker because he said something that made white people feel uncomfortable. I don't think black people had a problem. Most black people did not have a problem with his question. They might have debated him and fought it out with him, but they wouldn't have fired him. That's the point. And then you go back, you look at the way Stephen A. defended Mark Cuban when Mark Cuban made those stupid comments about being afraid of a black man in a hoodie. Doesn't mean Mark Cuban doesn't deserve to be forgiven, but it does mean that Mark Cuban needed to be confronted in an intelligent and empowered way. Now, they did invite Michael Eric Dyson on, and he and Stephen A. battled it out. But still, it's like, okay, wait a minute. So he's defended Mark Cuban for comments that were offensive to black men. Real black brothers out on the street are really living this reality. When you excuse racism and you say that racism by whites is being provoked, by black men. Notice I'm using the word provoke because that's a big word right now. You know, that racism by white men is being provoked by black men wearing hoodies. I mean, what the hell is that shit? Excuse my French. That's stupid. That's crazy. So, you know, you go back even further. I remember there was an Eagles, a Philadelphia Eagles player who used the N-word. Stephen A. defended that. That was offensive. I was offended. I was annoyed. Stephen A., what are you doing, man? Why do you defend any ignorant thing that comes out of a rich, famous person's mouth? He defended Kobe Bryant when Kobe disrespected Trayvon Martin. But ESPN never really sort of acted like the racial issues were a problem. They never said, well, you know, it's under review. We're going to, you know, think about suspending him or we're going to do whatever. I'm not saying they should have, but I'm saying notice that they didn't do it right now. Let's go to the other side. When someone made defamatory comments about the gay football player that played for the I don't know if he's gay or not. It was a bullying thing, and someone had called him, you know, some gay slurs or whatever. When homosexuality comes up, they're a lot more sensitive. When the gender issue came up, they were a lot more sensitive. Stephen A. gets booted out, and to me, what I see is this interesting, you know, contrast here. When you talk about issues that relate to gender / feminism, primarily feminism and gay rights, there's a different reaction than when you see issues that relate to race. A lot of black people were highly offended by what Stephen A. said when he defended Mark Cuban, but ESPN didn't care. However, in this particular case, when Stephen A. said something that really was relatively benign, I mean, don't get me wrong, it doesn't mean he shouldn't be confronted, but why not have a debate? Why not just box it out? Bring a feminist on so that she can debate with Stephen A. No, they didn't do that. They censored him. They made him give this contrite apology where they emasculated him on TV. That's exactly, I joke that they cut his testicles off, and that's exactly what they did. I'm sure Stephen A. is not comfortable with the fact that they did this to him, nor I'm sure is he comfortable with the fact that I'm even saying this. I mean, I've been on Stephen A.'s show a bunch of times when he was hosting, quite frankly. And so, you know, I wouldn't say we have a relationship, but I think we know of each other. And I don't think he's happy with the fact that people like myself are checking him and saying, okay, dude, they really embarrassed you. And then also, I don't think he's comfortable with the fact that black people are saying, why are you humiliating us by attacking us or, you know, throwing out these opinions that just don't make any sense? And then, you know, when it comes to black people, the reaction is, I don't give a damn. Well, I don't give a damn what the black community thinks. But yet, when it comes to feminism, he's very contrite. I'm truly, truly sorry. And this was the most egregious mistake of my career. I mean, come on, man. I mean, look, be consistent. Here's my bottom line here. Here's my bottom line. I'm not saying that Stephen A. should be censored. If Stephen A. has an opinion that differs from black people, that's fine. Now, every black person is not going to think alike. In fact, I respect a lot of conservative black opinions. I just hate it when liberals or conservatives try to control what black people think. That's what annoys me. But Stephen A., honestly, some of the stuff that he said about black men conducting ourselves more appropriately, those are conversations I've had with Minister Farrakhan. We both agree on that. In fact, Farrakhan used the term in our forum last year. He actually said black people are dead. And nobody wants to be around you when you are dead, because dead bodies rot and they stink. And he said, right now, our community is dead. And I agree. So it's not that what Stephen A. said was a problem, but the issue to me is that you have this bias where the network will allow certain opinions about African Americans, but yet will not support and defend African Americans when the situation calls for it. And at the same time, as soon as the extreme feminist lobby jumps up and down, they're responding to that, right? And I don't have a problem with feminism per se as a concept that supports equal rights for everyone, but I do have a problem with extreme feminism when it gets to the point of bullying people, and to the point where if they don't agree with what you said, then you need to ban them, you need to abolish them, you need to destroy them. To hell with that. That's bullshit. That's wrong. That it would be wrong if black people were doing it. It's wrong when white women are doing it. And so here's what ESPN, I think, needs to understand is choose one. Look, either let your analysts do their thing. Don't tell them we want you to give your honest opinion and then punish them for giving their honest opinion. Either let your analysts do their thing or avoid it altogether. You're already the worldwide leader in sports. Do sports. Tell me who won the Lakers game last night. Don't go and try to tell me what I need to be wearing as a black man so that Mark Cuban doesn't treat me like a nigger. I don't want to hear that shit. Excuse my French. And here's another interesting contrast, and this is the final point. There's a woman, her name is Beadle, I think Michelle Beadle, who works for ESPN. Now ESPN has a policy that says that employees are not allowed to bash each other in public, that you can't just get on Twitter and dog out your colleague down the hall. It's against company policy. I'm sure it's in a contract somewhere. I'm sure it's definitely in their company rules. I'm sure they all understand this when they take the job. Well, after Stephen A. made his remarks, which, again, some people didn't like, some people thought were fine. Most of the black people that are on my Facebook page think that the comments were okay. And those who disagree have either been quiet or they have had trouble finding evidence in terms of actual text to support their point of view. They can tell you, well, I don't like what Stephen A. said. It made me uncomfortable. But they can't tell you exactly what he said that made them feel that way. So here's the thing. Stephen A. makes these remarks that are debatable, and that's what the show does. You're supposed to debate. And she goes on Twitter against company policy and absolutely obliterates him. I mean, let me just look and see some of the things that she said about him. So she says, "So I was just forced to watch this morning's first take. I'll never feel clean again. I'm now aware that I can provoke my own beating. I'm thinking about wearing a miniskirt this weekend. I'd hate to think what I'd be asking by doing so." And then she says she was in an abusive relationship, which I'm very sorry to hear about that. I think abusive relationships are a problem. If you're in a relationship, by the way, don't hit anybody. And my daughter is, you know, said to me, look, don't hit anybody if you don't want to get hit back. So I don't think anybody should be hitting anybody. But at the same time, just for men and brothers who are listening, a gentleman does not hit a lady back. If a lady hits you, you get out of that situation unless she has pulled a gun out on you and you have to punch her to get out of a life or death scenario, which doesn't happen very often. But for the most part, keep your hands to yourself, because when the police come to your house, if you are a black man, they will take you to jail, not her. Let's see what else she said. To spread a message that we should not provoke is wrong. Violence isn't the victim's issue, it's the abuser's. To insinuate otherwise is irresponsible and disgusting. Walk away. Okay. So she's calling him irresponsible, she's calling him disgusting. She's saying, you know, she's really saying some things publicly that would amount to bashing her colleague. Now, again, if you're talking about free debate and all this other stuff, then maybe that's what ESPN should allow all the time. But given that their company policy says that you're not supposed to do this to a colleague, my question is this. Why is Stephen A. suspended for just doing his job? You asked for his opinion. He gave it, but yet you're suspending him. Yet this white woman, again, white female privilege, is allowed to go out in public and bash because she feels upset about something he said. Notice she didn't quote him really, other than the word provoke. She hung on that one word. The man talked for 5-10 minutes, but she hangs on one word, provoke, which actually is a valid word in a certain context. If you punch somebody in the face, you have provoked them to punch you back. Understand that. But she hung on one word, rants on Twitter, goes off on him, violates company policy. But yet they do nothing. I'll tell you this much. If there had been a black woman who decided that she wanted to rant about something racist that Skip Bayless said, and Skip Bayless is kind of like a sports version of Bill O'Reilly on ESPN. They create this contrast, Archie Bunker, Sherman Hill, Archie Bunker, George Jefferson kind of thing going on. That's kind of what they're doing. They're kind of feeding on and profiting from the racial tension that exists in America. They got a bunch of Negroes fighting against one powerful white man, and it creates the same environment that the O'Reilly factor creates, where O'Reilly gets these black people to come on to fight with him. 6 years ago, I told Fox News I was never going on their network again. And I've been on Fox News probably over 100 times. But after I realized what was going on, I backed away and said, I'm never coming on your network again. I haven't been on since. But long story short, I'm not dogging out ESPN's business model. My PhD's in finance. I'm a finance professor, so I understand you got to make your money. You're doing your thing. But I'm going to call it like it is. They need to stay away from social commentary. Either do it right or don't do it at all. That means get qualified people to talk about these issues or don't talk about them at all. Let your people talk about them in an honest way, or don't talk about it at all. Don't act like bitches and cowards. And I'm talking about male and female bitches here. Don't be a bitch and a coward when the heat gets too hot, when you have asked for the heat in the first place. You can't go after the heat just to make money, but then run away from the heat when people start getting mad at you for what you had to say. You have to pick one or the other. Personally, if I were running ESPN, thinking about the business model, I would just stick to sports. This social commentary thing is getting out of hand. You're offending a lot of people. You're hurting a lot of people's feelings. You're hurting me as a black man because I'm disappointed that so many black people watch this show. Notice they get more, half of their audience approximately comes from African-American males, from what I understand. And the reason that this audience comes from so many black men is because black men are the highest, most unemployed group in America. So because so many brothers don't have jobs, many of them are sitting home watching First Take on ESPN every morning. And what's interesting to me is that you can sit around and you can debate all day about why black men shouldn't wear hoodies, so because that's causing their discrimination. But you won't sit and talk about why black men can't get jobs, why white corporations are not hiring them, why white people are discriminating against them while they're being victims of this racial discrimination. Yet somehow you can have this debate about how we provoke discrimination by wearing a goddamn hoodie. Excuse my French. I'm sorry. I cussed and I didn't mean to say that, but I'm angry right now because this really makes me mad. So the bottom line at the end of the day is that ESPN needs to grow up. I don't know if I like Stephen A or dislike him. He probably gets exactly what he wants. Half the time I like him, half the time I don't. I mean, and that's, but at the end of the day, I respect him. And that's what, I think matters at the end of the, that, I think that's what matters to him is respect. That's what matters to me is whether or not you're hearing what I'm saying, not whether you like me or not. So I want Stephen A to keep his job. He's good at what he does. I understand why they're paying him so much money, but at the end of the day, you can't keep playing both sides of the fence. It's really getting irritating. I'm Dr. Boyce Watkins from Your Black World. Please take care. God bless and have a wonderful day. I'm gone. Peace.